We are beginning tonight with a Central Coast visit from former Vice President Al Gore here for the Panetta Lecture Series.
Now, the topic of the lecture series tonight was, can we save the planet that sustains us? But another issue took center stage, the BP oil spill in the Gulf of Mexico. And Gore did not mince words for BP and how it has handled this mess. Action News reporter Stephanie Truong has the story live from our Salinas newsroom.
Dan, the oil spill has raised so much controversy that at least 7 congressional committees are looking into it, including the Senate Environment Committee, which will hold its second hearing tomorrow. But ahead of that, tonight, Al Gore took aim at BP.
You know, I'm a recovering politician. I'm on about step 9.
With humor dotting the way, former Vice President and Nobel laureate Al Gore brought serious talk of global climate change to the Central Coast.
I believe that a group of people who are committed, decide to do something about it, can make a difference.
He was the special guest for Monday night's Panetta Lecture Series, titled Saving the Planet That Sustains Us. But the passion peaked around one topic, the BP oil spill in the Gulf of Mexico.
I respect a lot of the folks at BP, and they've done some good things. But ladies and gentlemen, I know a cover-up when I see one.
BP has not released specific figures on the amount of oil spilled since the April 20th explosion. The former vice president says the company's decision to bar the scientific community from investigating the spill is both unfair to the American people and inexcusable.
And they say, oh, no, the answer is no, was their direct quote. The answer is no. That's irrelevant, they said, to how we respond to it. Well, I beg to differ. The public has an interest in understanding not only what went wrong, but the extent of the damage.
Before moving on to the next topic, he drew an analogy between the Gulf oil spill and global warming, hoping his numbers would hit home.
Every 3 seconds, the average coal-fired generating plant here in the United States emits 3 times as much global warming pollution by weight, number of tons, as the amount of oil every day in the highest estimate in the Gulf. And there are 1,400 of them in the United States alone.
Now,
here's the difference
between the oil. Now, there was a crowd of protesters outside the Golden State Theater in downtown Monterey tonight where the lecture was held, with people holding up signs like Al Gore and his junk science. But with that aside, for the most part, this fourth and final lecture in the Panetta series went off without a hitch. Dan?
All right. Thanks very much, Stephanie. The fallout from all of this is just beginning. The federal official overseeing offshore drilling announced his retirement today amid criticism that federal regulators got too close to the industry and didn't do their jobs.